In this video, I will show you how to use Keysight Electromagnetic Platform RFPro within Synopsys Custom Compiler using a millimeter wave low noise amplifier. The LNA operates at 28 GHz and has been designed on a GlobalFoundries 22FDX technology. First, let's activate the RFPro menu by turning it on with the Tools menu. Then, you can create a new view with the menu RFPro New. Enter the name you want and click on OK. RFPro will then prompt for the substrate selection. Here, we'll choose the one that is corresponding to the current design technology. RFPro opens and then displays a 3D view of the current design, and we can start to prepare the simulation. Let's rename the analysis first for a more convenient usage when back to the final circuit simulation. RFPro works on the open access database and then preserves all the pins, nets, components, and connectivity that have been defined in the custom compiler layout. You are able to see the nets displayed here and how they are connected in 3D. Components are also kept, and we will use this to partition what should be sent to RFPro EM solvers and what should be left out of the EM simulation, either because it's an active structure or because it's of no interest to you for the simulation you want to do. All of this can be done inside RFPro without creating multiple layout views inside Custom Compiler. Here, as an example, let's choose the APMOM and the active devices out of the EM simulation. The view will be automatically refreshed, displaying only what will be ultimately simulated here, the inductors, pads, and the interconnections. To prepare the final circuit simulation, let's drag the components left out to the analysis so that RFPro could automatically further stitch these components to the output of the EM simulation, saving a lot of manual and error-prone rewiring. For the EM simulation, we also need ports. We can use the layout pins and send them onto the ports section of the analysis. RFPro will automatically create ports, referring the selected pins to the closest reference. Here, the backside cover of the silicon technology. In the simulation settings, let's increase the maximum frequency to 40 GHz and choose momentum as the solver. Momentum has very few options, and we recommend to use the default settings as much as possible. Still, here we advise to turn the generation 2 of momentum that is very well suited for RFIC technologies. Let's now run the simulation. Once the simulation is over, let's generate the final schematic view. As said before, this intends to reconnect the different parts of the analysis. The ports, the S parameters box coming from momentum, one can spot this is a 156 ports S parameter, the components that have been ignored in the momentum simulations that are now present at the circuit level, already rewired to the 156 S parameters component. Let's now reuse that schematic view inside an HSpice simulation. The top schematic has already been prepared, and we will use the hierarchy editor to use the view we just generated with RFPro with this top test bench. Now, opening an SAE state, we can run an S parameter simulation with HSpice and display the final gain of this LNA. As you can see, the LNA peaks around 28 GHz as expected. As a summary, you can seamlessly use Keysight RFPro inside Synopsys Custom Compiler to generate views embedding EM effects for further reuse with your HSpice simulation. Thanks for watching!